This is where I want you to engage. I want you to really, 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 really engage the core. Okay, so really engage so that you can feel the burn, okay? So, first thing I'm gonna do, you see how I'm in like a tabletop position? This is cute, right? Your butt, your booty's out, you're like checking yourself out, you're like, yeah. But what you need to do is walk one hand out, and then tuck the hips down so you're straight, and then bring your hands back so they're right under the shoulders, okay? So your booty's no longer out, it's here. Simple movement. Now bring your toes to the floor where you can like tap your toes down, and then you're just gonna lift and push your heels back and come down. This is 1 minute. Now, as your knees come down, you go back to that simple crunch position and you tuck under. So what you're doing is pushing the heels back and you're tucking under. You're pushing the heels back and you're tucking under. Again, not a hard movement to do, but you have to have your shoulders, wrists, elbow in line. Now you keep going. I don't want your booty in the air when you come back. Like, this is not a dance move. You ain't at the club, like, whoa, right? You're just here and you bring your knees down and up, just like that. Here we go. Now what I want you to do is come down, interlock your hands like you're praying. Look straight down into the triangle, right? Push the heels back, tuck the hips under as if you were in that crunch position. Make sure your shoulders and elbows are in line here, and you just look down and you hold. Now, if you get a little tired, you can still do that knee down, knee up. But in this position, what I want you to do is really just engage and look. Now, two, now you just come to a high point. You're like, Shaun, I've been in this position. Yes, you have. Now, what I want you to do is tap, one, tap, touch the elbow, tap, and come back. Now, other side, tap, one, knee, touch the elbow, tap, and come back. Now, listen, when your knee comes in, you're gonna do two crunches as your knee comes in and back. There you go. Crunch, crunch, in and back. Now this movement's gonna be a little tricky, but this is how you engage your core. When people go to fall, oh, they engage their core and they come up, right? They come down. So what I want you to do is basically fall forward into the plank position, heels come up, and push back. Now when you push back, you have to engage your core. You can't push back and have a tight core, a loose core, because you'll fall down. So you're here, I'm up, and I'm pushing back, okay? I'm here, and I'm pushing back. You gotta keep your arms straight as you push back and engage. It's tough, it's hard, but I know you can do it. It's a simple movement, but it actually causes you to do some work. Now, if you gotta keep your feet down and walk your back and then come up, that's fine too, but what I want you to do is fall forward, engage the core, and pull back. Now this last move in this series, what you're gonna do is bring your hands, you're gonna do a reverse crunch, put your toes down, crunch up, crunch down, arms out, arms in. Crunch up, crunch down, arms out, in. Keep going, up, down, out, in. Again, up, down, out, and you keep going, keep going. Now what's very important that we don't do an abs lock is we stretch the lower back when you do something like that. So you push back, go in child pose, breathe, and then you come back, and then you're gonna reach out. Okay, you come in, push back, child pose, breathe. This is something you can do in the morning, and extend up. All right, that was the second workout, second ab workout. I hope you did really good. Make sure you join me for the third ab workout that's gonna be on your back.